Good morning, artists. Happy Tuesday. You can see I've already got some stuff ready to go. Hope everyone's still doing all right. Alright, so this is not what I started yesterday. I started that little drawing, enjoying it. Didn't really have a plan for what was going. So then last night, my sister and I and a friend, we watched a pretty crazy, all-over-the-place movie called Jupiter Ascending. Which, if you want something that's just kind of crazy sci-fi fun, yay. It was. It was crazy and it was sci-fi and it was fun. But definitely the part that I enjoyed the most out of all of it was the hats. There were people there and they had just the best kind of hat designs. And I don't know why, but that's just something I'm really into, is these created cultures that have these really interesting, intricate, almost impossible hats. Maybe that's why I got into Egyptian art so much. It was just that it had all these great hats. Tall. I like building them when we do them in class. We do an Egyptian hat project. Hopefully we'll have time to be able to do that once we get back into normal school. But any excuse I have to make a big hat or a mask or something like that, I'm going to take it. So I thought, why not? Since we haven't had too many requests from students on needing help for different things for their work at home, I'm just going to do a little project. We'll see how long it goes. I wanted to create some characters that had these very interesting Headpieces, hat pieces, masks, whatever we felt like. We'll go super anime with it since that's really my style. So then of course I had to pick a theme. Because I'm all about organizing and themes and making charts, lists, color coding. So I think what we're going to be trying to do is do a sort of Chinese zodiac inspired designs. So of course we have to first start off with our little rat character. In the year of the rat, let me get my little notes upon this, because of course I had to look some stuff up. Year of the rat. They're known for their intelligence, their interest in wealth and collecting wealth. They can be a little bit judgmental. And they definitely know how to grab an opportunity when it comes up. So this one's going to be equal parts mask and hat. Let's go to fantasy. I don't want him to look like an elf. So because I tend to be really organized about these kind of things, you can see I already kind of prepped my paper, created little boxes for everyone. These circles, I'm not quite sure yet what I want to do with them. I may just end up using them to do some kind of little symbol for each of these families, we'll call them. Is that a Wesker? Dogs are up and on alert. The squirrels have realized that the neighborhood is mostly quiet. So they are getting bold about running out into the road. That's all right. Our first couple of streams had to have them roaming about anyway. So the plan first is also, I hunted down, finally found these screen tones that comic artists in Japan, I don't think they really use it as much anymore. It's so much easier to do it digitally, but they used to use these stickers to create like the shading and such. No squirrels in the back? Nope, they went way back to the window.
We couldn't find the ducks outside either.
Oh, is that what they were looking at?
Yeah, there's
ducks. Ducks have returned. So I'm going to use a Micron 01 to outline this. Hope everyone is still doing well and staying real safe at home. I know we've got a lot more families now at home. This is the news from the governor the other day. Thank goodness. Hopefully this will really slow things down and help everyone to stay safe and well and not overwhelm our hospitals and all that. Since this is Year of the Rat, I want to have a little bit judgmental, little bit of judgy eyes, we might say. Definitely want to have a bit of a cool appearance, like I will take care of myself, I am not worried about others. A little bit haughty, a little bit superior. dry. So before I start erasing, check these out, guys. Old school. I bought a ton of these back when I'd first heard them and got really into them. I'm glad I did, because I don't know if you can even really get them much anymore. I'm gonna pull out all the shading type ones. God, I had so many of them. I had a piece somewhere that I'd used a bunch of these snowflake ones on, which was pretty cool. I had other ones that were used just for backgrounds. So we'll keep the stripes handy. We'll keep the shadings handy. Keep you kind of handy. These are more kind of fabric and clothes and texture types. So. We may not need them for our first guy, so we'll kind of set them back in for now. Let's get a dark one and a lighter one. And something right in the middle. Okay. We'll be using those in a moment, too. Oh, I'm sorry, there we go. Erasing that shakes the whole world. Let's see if I can get it so it's not shaking the camera nearly so much. That's better. I moved my phone onto a... Since that's what I'm using to stream on, I moved it onto a little platform, so my setup is even now a little crazier than it used to be. But hopefully this will keep it from the camera from shaking when I have to move the table and I bump it and I erase. So before I do too much of adding in the shading, I like to go in and kind of thicken up some lines, kind of adds a little bit of a shadow effect. and the little story that is starting to form for these characters. The rat being the first animal in the Chinese zodiac. It's going to have to be the first of these noble-ish families in my young adult dystopian future. Since they are crafty and very intelligent, they set up this idea of these strong families. Wearing these masks to make them more about their family rather than necessarily individuals, perhaps. Their identity being tied into their family name more than what they themselves accomplish so that they can keep it going. Now, it's been a while since I have used any of these. Fingers crossed that I remember how to do it well enough. Hopefully they're still sticky enough. If not, I'll hide them. Very short demo. So you put the sticker down, and then we're going to get out an X-Acto knife. And then you have to super carefully try to cut through just the sticker. Without cutting all the way through your paper. So you can imagine that it took a little while to get the hang of this. Try to save as many of the pieces as I can. This is also why it's nice to use the Micron pen, because then you can do these nice bold lines. Because a thinner line, it would be harder to trace it. So by having these wider lines, it makes it a little bit easier. Thank you.
It's pretty thin, but I made it work. It's almost too bad that this art style has gone away. And granted, it's so much easier for the comic artist to just do it digitally and not have to spend all this time lining and cutting and all of that. Well, I guess it's really only a step up from doing all of the dotting yourself. That's so satisfying. At some point, I'll have to do another video for you guys of me working on one of my foam core carvings. That is also incredibly satisfying. Is that? Ooh. Don't knock things over. So let's see this little piece. Big enough to go on you? Hi Kenneth, yeah, this is an old manga technique. Way back in the day, when I was in college, they started selling these. A couple art stores got into it, picked it up. That was when anime really started to become big over here. Dragon Ball Z was out, Sailor Moon was out, everything was... Pokemon just killed the world, you know? And now we're gonna need a little bit on this other shoulder.
might have to do the tiniest bit of cheating on this one, but that's okay. So that was our lighter tone. Let's get our medium tone next. So me not wanting to waste, I always folded these over so that it'll be easy to restick it. And as always, get as close into the corner as you could. These are called illust screens. You can not. What was the other name for them called, Mel? These screen tones. Manga screen tones. If you look them up, I really don't know if they're things that you can even find very much anymore. It's a art that is not nearly as popular anymore. Just because it's so much easier to do everything on computers. I think at one point I did try to look them up on Amazon to see if we could find them, and they were just way more expensive than I remember them being. And I kind of went, yeah, maybe not. I'd considered getting them for my classes that do, when we do the comic. I thought, well, maybe I can find them. Maybe they're super cheap now, and something I can teach them how to do. But not with how expensive they are. They're not sticking like they used to. I'll probably have to put some kind of a seal over it afterwards. You found for 20 to find 25. It's not too bad. I mean, I've had these for a long time. I haven't done too many projects with them, so I still have quite a bit left. And as long as you are mindful of how much you're using and just being real careful and try to get them as precise as you can probably get them to last quite a while. Another thing you can do with these too, if you don't want to end up using buying too many of them, if you get a really light shaded one, so this one's a little bit darker, you get one that's a little bit lighter, and you can layer them. You can put one over the top of the other, and that will create a darker tone as well. So you don't necessarily have to go and buy a light, medium, and dark. You could just layer it up as much as you need to. Thank you. I can get this to sit even a little bit lower. Hold on. Sorry if this shakes for a second. I'm going to see if I can move a little closer. Oh, boy. It's a little dangerous, it's a little precarious, but hopefully that's a little bit closer so you guys can have an easier view. Dirty there for a moment. Looks like a weird goatee. Never mind. He's fine. Alright. Let's get the darker one out. Thank you. table. So just as a reminder, if you guys want any requests for future streams, if you think of something you'd like me to demonstrate that you're having some trouble with, you can mention it in the chat while we're on live. You can email it to me. You can find me on YouTube. Leave a comment when I post this video up on YouTube so I can see what you're looking for. I'm on Facebook, I'm on Instagram and Twitter, even though I'm not the best at checking those. Spots a little darker. A little bit how the layering works there. Just by adding another little layer of it, gives you just a slightly darker tone. That's long enough nails for helping the whole pieces down. Stay there. So use this darker shade on this outfit here. A little bit of this cloak showing. Since Rat family, they are certainly rich, but they're wise about it. So they don't always show it off as much as some of the other ones might. They're sneaky. So even though they wear nice things, they try to keep a level of simplicity so that nobody suspects exactly how much they have. I'm looking at it's looking cool. So as part of my attempt to, you know, help stay sane in these crazy times, I do have scheduled personal art time as well during the day. So I may end up working a little bit more on this, otherwise it's going to take us the entire shutdown to get the whole thing done. But, so, you might end up seeing other ones finished a little bit sooner. I do want to think of some kind of little symbol I can sneak in here as well. I might add that in. But so far, it's looking pretty nice. Let's use a little bit of this. The tiniest of slivers. Tweezers up for the next one. I'm gonna be working that tiny. This is why you comic people, if you ever went and got the comic packs from the store, I know that like places like Michael's or Joann's used to have, you know, your how to draw manga set. And they would give these huge papers that were like way too big for any actual book. But that was on purpose. They would have you do them super large, and then they would shrink them for the print, and it would make it look crazy detailed. Look at that. Do some very shortening sometime, Kenneth. Rat's pretty much done. Let me scoot in a second. This is the one I started right at the end of the stream yesterday. I find that doing the hands and stuff are the easiest for doing the foreshortening. The bodies are still tough for me, but having something that you could almost do like a one-point perspective on definitely helps. So let me see what I gotta. Camera, do not fall yet. We are not finished. So, quick version. If you're doing the idea of somebody is reaching towards you, I find if you start off, kind of get the head shape and then get an idea of how big you want the hand to be, the arm is then going to shrink down to join where the rest of the body is. And then you can start growing from there. It's usually not the small things, the hands or the feet, that end up being the problem. It's usually trying to get the arm and the leg to look a little more natural as you go. So trying to thin it at the wrist, trying to give a little indication of where the elbows would be. Sometimes separating out the body into here's the chest, here's the stomach, and they're overlapping each other really dramatically. Here are the hips. That can then help when you start to add in details. Especially trying to sneak in, like, whatever they might be wearing. Dramatics. Skirt. You can't see it. Let me scoot it. And then again, if you have something going further away, how big is it? And then it has to grow towards the rest. So anytime you're trying to work on making something do that foreshortening to make something look like it's coming closer, trying to keep in mind that perspective idea of you're heading towards something, and you have to get smaller as you go and at an even pace that will really help out with that. And remember, you guys can send me pictures of things you're working on. I can try to help you out and stuff on the next streams, since we're almost out of time today. Even if you're not a student and you still have a question, I am a teacher of all things. Current student, former student, not a student. Alright, it's 11 o'clock. Time for me to go and start my homework, but we'll come back tomorrow. 10 o'clock. and probably work on some more of this awesome piece. I'm liking them so far. Thanks you guys for tuning in, and stay safe, stay healthy. Oh, we gotta end as normal. Where's the dog? It's gonna be tradition now. We gotta always end checking on the puppies. Wiley's on the couch today. Hi, Bubbas. Look how adorable he is. You're a good boy. Wesker's guarding the yard. Say hi, Wesker. Oh man, takes his job very seriously. All right, guys, thanks for tuning in. See you tomorrow.